My inner city. Truth be told, my inner playground covers a vast expanse of my mental territory, larger conceptually than all of Los Angeles, with skyscraping clusters of meeting rooms and huge high-tech amusement centers where I can and do amuse myself and abuse myself, where I entertain myself, where I can scare myself and heal myself and applaud myself and enjoy myself. And not just myself. It's not just the two of me in here, you know. Least case scenario, there's one, the I I'm thinking about, and two, the I that's doing the thinking, and then there's the third I, the I that's thinking about the both of us. This discovery of the third I leads to two very useful conclusions. One, there's an inner we that is really me, and vice versa. And two, all this inner we, me really wants to do is play with each other. There's my entire consciousness, created, inhabited by an all-encompassing, all-knowing we, or me. An alternate reality, vivid as thought, elaborate beyond belief, built by me for myself, for one reason and one reason only, so I could have more fun. So I could, when necessary, transform the world.